So now for the second half of the session, then we'll meditate on the six advantages of reflecting on death. Here in this verse, Atisha is saying, one of the drawbacks of not remembering death is that nothing you do becomes dharma. So you know, one of the advantages then is that it makes your motivation, the dharma motivation, reflecting on death. Other verses. Anyway, all those verses you can also bring into the meditation. They're in the outline, if you have the outline handy. And okay, so here are the six advantages of thinking about death. So just like last time, we can spend the time. We have about 20 minutes. We can spend the time going through them one by one. And then if you have time left after that, you can think in, you know, a different, in your own kind of original way. Think of the, if, you know, different other advantages that maybe don't easily fit in any of these, or different ways to think about them. So yeah, and then you can bring in different verses and things if you like. If you have outlines or other notes in front of you. So think of in different ways about the advantages of thinking about death, and especially how it's beneficial for your to make your motivation a dharma motivation, and to help you abandon the eight worldly concerns in daily life. And so forth. Yeah, so 20 minutes thinking about the six advantages of thinking about death. I'll draw your meditation to a close. So let's dedicate briefly at the end of this session. So think of any merit you've created, the others in the group have created, and rejoice. And especially think of all the merit created by all the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas since beginning of time until now. We've all reflected on impermanence and death. And then think of all the other ordinary sentient beings like ourselves, especially those creating merit in relation to impermanence and death by helping the sick and dying, for themselves meditating on impermanence and death, making prayers for those who died and so forth. Rejoice in all that. So we can dedicate briefly, especially by whatever merit we've created. May all sentient beings be free from every form of suffering, have every form of well-being, especially those who are sick, may they quickly recover, those who are dying or near death, may their minds be completely free of any regret or disturbance or fear, may their minds be peaceful and virtuous, altruistic and full of compassion, loving kindness. And faith, full of faith, object of chosen object of refuge. And may all those who have recently died take precious human rebirth, a rebirth in a pure land, in whatever conditions are most beneficial for them. And especially James's cousin Michael, who's very sick and nearing death. May be free from any pain, discomfort, and in his mind, may his mind be clear, lucid, peaceful, extremely virtuous. And then bring to mind any other prayers you'd like to make. So may those your prayers also be fulfilled in accordance with your wishes. All right, so now we'll take a 15-minute break and we'll resume. And 3:45 there now.